fun as hell from my head down to my nails. My man tripping cause I got another sale. He still buy me YSL. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I could get it by myself. These I could get it by myself. I'ma get it by myself. Yeah. I'ma get it either way. I don't even gotta say what I want when I want. They just put it.
Hey everybody, it's the coach, and this is Madden 20 on EA Sports. Straight ahead, we've got a terrific matchup on tap between the Atlanta Falcons and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. I'll have scores around the league for you at the half, but it's time for a little football. So we'll hand it over to our broadcast team, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, coach, thanks. EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us on. It's the final 3 weeks of the season. Still plenty to play for here as we're underway in week 15. This is taken at his 4. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So out come the Bucs now for their first drive. They'll be led out by their 6'4" quarterback, the former number one overall pick in 2015, Jameis Winston.
I'm absolutely eager to watch him play in this game because here we are, week 15. Not a lot of games left down the stretch. But will he get outside of himself trying to make huge plays in order to try and win an MVP? Because he's not in the number one spot right now.
No, he's not. I think everyone consensus thinks that way. You hope he doesn't get outside of himself right now, though, because that could really get their offense out of sync. And it's been in sync most of this year. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. They'll run with Hunt on 2nd down. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker. And now it's 3rd down.
Ready. Two ready.
Mike, 45.
Hey, 5 on 50.
They'll try to run for the first down with Hunt. And he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. He lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to 4th down.
Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
And he's got a man. It's the tight end Howard complete. 4th down, no problem. 19 yards that time, and now it's 1st and 10. Two first downs have him up near midfield now on 1st and 10. Jameis to throw it. Oh, he got position on him and he pulls it in. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one goes for 24 yards.
That was an excellent read right there. Saw cover one. That means it's just a single high safety. So you know if you throw the ball to the outside part of the field, help is going to be a little bit late getting there. And he puts one out there for a big-time completion.
The completion good for 3 and it's 2nd down.
And, partner, I think that was a great example that not all tight ends are created equal. Because everything was right. Got the completion. But he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
To throw again on 2nd down. Winston, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's 3rd down. Here comes the 7th play of this opening drive. They've moved it well, but here's 3rd down. They'll throw again. Winston, escaping the pressure right. And that is incomplete. This offense.
Everyone tells me it's a bit of a mess.
Now on EA Sports at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa. We're in the first quarter of action, and it's the Buccaneers who are in control of the football. They've already gone for it and made it once on this opening drive. They're going to try it again on fourth down. Now Winston on fourth down. And he finds Howard complete. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. Bruce Arians takes a shot there, but his guys come up empty. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. They'll run for the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
Here we go on second and 12. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's Devin White, the linebacker. And he will score. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Extra point by Gay is up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Now the Falcons offense gets ready to head back onto the field. A partner, just looking at some of the struggles they've had this season, the playoffs are not in their future. As they start to peer toward the offseason, what moves might they make?
I think the running back position, and I know we talk all the time about the NFL being a passing league, but the teams that run the ball effectively, they're the ones that go deep into the playoffs and go to the Super Bowl. They have to upgrade here. And you and I both know in recent years in the draft, people have shied away from taking a runner early. But if there's that special one there, I say they go get him.
Plays like we just saw there, that's why they're up right now. And the defense, they're doing their job.
Yeah, it starts with the guys up front. So when you talk with GMs who are putting together a team, a lot of them say, we're going to build from the inside out. Because if you control the line of scrimmage, you control the rest of the ball game. And that's what we're seeing here. They're actually playing in the offense's backfield, not necessarily just playing at the line of scrimmage.
And down he'll go at the 25.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well. But when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you've got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn into 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
On fourth down, Matt Hawk is on to punt. Fielded just inside the 20. That'll be put in the books as a 53-yard punt. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. With the Bucs offense making their way back out on the field, let's take a look at the playoff picture, Charles, coming into the weekend in the NFC. And it's right about this time of year you start to say this is when the cream rises to the top. Week 15, 3 weeks left to go. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
And that's a great example of ball skills right there, partner. You and I do a lot of games, and I can't tell you how many guys look to run with the football before they've intercepted it. So that's a nice job of focusing on the task at hand and coming away with the interception.
And the first play of the drive there is incomplete. The intended target was Calvin Ridley, but it'll be second down. They work again from the 38 on second and 10. They run Devontae Freeman. And forget about finding a lane. He barely had time to look up before he was planted in the backfield. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Throwing on third and long. Now. He's got his man here. It's Green. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. Last play, they didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. Now they gain all those 40 yards here. On, for an six, offense that has not found the end zone yet, that's a big play.
There's the spark right there. The big play that they needed. Now they've got to go ahead and finish this drive and put this ball in the end zone.
And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. That'll wind up going for a loss of 4. And that'll bring up a 2nd and goal. Now from the 7, here's 2nd and goal. Here's a 2nd and 7. And he's going to be dropped back at the 15-yard line. Noah Spence just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7. Couple of plays set him the wrong way, and now they face a 3rd and 14. Operating from the gun. Knapp swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Devontae Freeman with touchdown number 8 on the year, as they are now on the board here in the first half. CD, it seemed like they were so focused on the guys out wide, they forgot about him out of the backfield.
That's a really good point, because you've got to communicate, and oftentimes when you start counting receivers, that's exactly what you do. You start from the widest receiver, work your way inside. Who gets lost sometimes? The back in the backfield. That's exactly what happened there.
And he got into the end zone. A look at Jameis Winston now as he gears up to lead this offense again. And it was his interception on the last drive that wound up leading to a game-tying touchdown.
And somehow, you can make this a positive, though. You know why? Game-tied now. So you're not protecting the lead. So you're not playing that way. You've got to go get the lead again. So maybe it loosens him up a little bit and allows him to go ahead and be a little more free in his play.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Winston. This one complete to Scott Miller. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Last play, they got stuffed at the line. Different story here, over 20 yards.
And that was a heck of a shot right there by Jameis Winston. Boy, he has a superior right arm, doesn't he? You saw him play baseball.
Yeah, and he's actually a switch hitter in baseball. Outfielder, and then, of course, a very hard-throwing pitcher. That's translated well in the National Football League.
That it has. When he has to make that throw on a line, he's got plenty of arm to do it.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. A little too aggressive defensively, and the flag comes out.
And no one trying to cover is going to like a call going against them, but you have to like the effort there. Went for the interception, just unable to get it, and the flag did come out.
Ready, blue ready. 58, come on. Yeah, let's get that ball.
Green, come with me.
And go. On 1st and 10, Winston. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. In the pocket, chucked it away. Flag comes down.
So you got to move a little bit, right? Know where you are on the field. Have some awareness. Tackle to tackle. You got to get outside of that tackle box in order to get that done.
They lose the yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly 2nd and long. Now Winston. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. It was DJ Swearinger right there on the coverage. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. And now here's a deep shot that's complete. That one goes for 30 yards.
I know we love our jobs, and pretty much any play we see, we're pretty, you know, excited about. The big plays, let's face it, that's what we absolutely live for. How about that one?
That was great. And what our camera missed was the fist pump from the sideline after that catch. They're fired out. It's a big game. They try to run on first down, but this defense says no dice. They stop him a couple yards behind the line of scrimmage. It'll wind up being a loss of two, and that'll make it second and 12. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. To throw is Winston. And this is caught by Evans. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. The Bucs passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. First and goal at the 4-yard line. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll send you cross state to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have all the stats and all the scores from games going on during another busy Sunday in the National Football League. From the shotgun, it's Winston. Into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Scott Miller, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Bucs have taken the lead. Here's Gay now to add the extra point. Certainly there are good things about quick strike offenses that score fast, but a long drive can also work to your advantage as well.
In so many ways, Brandon, because number one, you get them tired, but the big one is mentally. They can't figure out how to slow you down, how to get off the field, how to get the ball back. They go to the bench wondering, what are we going to do next time in order to stop those guys?
This is taken at the 3. And nice work on the return as he'll start their drive just past the 30-yard line. And back onto the field now comes Devontae Freeman. He's just been looking for some space. Yeah, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people.
Down the numbers. There he goes. Touchdown, Falcons. Calvin Ridley hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right, because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the Tampa Bay offense now heading back out onto the field. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
To begin the drive, here's a handoff to Hunt. And the running lane's non-existent in this first half as they'll stop him behind the line. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Anytime you call an inside running play, you just know there should be a lot of congestion there. You're counting on your offensive line to take control of the line of scrimmage. That didn't happen in this case. That play got bottled up.
It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice, solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
On third down, here's Hunt. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. Now the offense going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They'll try to throw now. Winston. They'll go screen here to Hunt. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up six. Now Jameis trying to hurry his crew to the line. Looking to throw again on second down. Winston. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Holding. Let's get the call. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpires get different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
Now Jameis on second down. Finds his man, Watson, over the middle. And he's going to be ripped down by the face mask at the end of this, and that's going to add 15 more onto the end of this thing. Tack on 15 more for the face mask, and that becomes a huge play.
Big pass gets caught on you. You're doing everything possible to get him on the ground, and sometimes you end up grabbing the face mask.
A first down throw for Winston. That's going to be caught. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Scott Miller in the final seconds of the first half as his guys are able to regain the lead. So they're able to break the tie just before halftime. Now they just don't want anything crazy to happen on the ensuing kickoff.
Yeah, they want to just add the extra point, get the kickoff taken care of, and get to the locker room with the lead that they fought so hard to get.
Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. This is taken at his four. And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one, go to the locker room, start over.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is taken at the three. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Throwing again, now. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. He's going to have the hook up to Gage. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
But give the defensive guys a little bit of credit. They didn't let the deep ball beat them on that play, did they?
No, the drag, that guy can be your safety valve. We saw it right there.
Yeah, and it picked up a first down for him, too.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Again, they'll run with Freeman. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
To throw on third down. Knapp. This to Jarwin. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. A nice pickup there. 18 yards. First down, Falcons. First down. So from Buccaneer territory now, it's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. A nice burst there as they'll get about 7 that time on the first down run. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll get 3 down to the 34-yard line.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
This will be the 8th play of the drive, and it's 3rd and inches. Looking to throw. Now, under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Carl Nassib, he's the culprit, and that is now his 13th sack of the season as his great year continues. They get the sack on the blitz, but it was 3rd and inches. Are you surprised like I am they weren't running the football there?
I'm right there with you. I would have thought at worst, quarterback sneak, try and pick up the first down and move on. But instead, I think they thought they could catch him by surprise.
Down here,
level up at any moment. Spitting like a semi, only give me semicolon. Couple zeros like I'm sending yell nets. Every flow is unmatched, and I better get set in. Finish them,
finish them.
Mess around with me and I diminish them all. Even if I ever did the minimum all.
In the end result, I'm better killing them all.
Rogue one, but I got a team with me. Batman when I got a thing with me. I get mean, I get green. Show the whole game what's never been seen. Cook it up, go Super Saiyan, go tank. Anything I ever
now. Every woman is now. What state prop you looking bleak now? I was home to sleep designing sheets now. 30 different missions. When I speak, they listen. Couldn't find the social fishing. Who the crew? It wasn't you. I know it's true because you look like the opposition. Run it up, greatest ever sums it up. I ain't have a lot when I was coming up. Kind of made my stomach turn when I brung it up. Wait.
Cook it up, gourmet. I go Super Saiyan, go tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank. Cook it up, gourmet. Super Saiyan Gold Tank. Anything I ever do is top rank. Got more bars than a Shawshank.
It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You were Joe like Chappelle Show. This so perennial, do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. I just had to let you know. It's the young, incredible, honestly unforgettable. You were Joe like Chappelle Show. This so perennial, do this for my millennials. I be murdering any flow. Yeah. I just had to let you know. Yeah. Give me that work and I can sell it. I put it on the line like I ain't selfish. Nah. The story f***ed up if I let you tell it. Put my heart and soul in, so you feel it. I ain't never faking, I'm the realest. Tupac in the prison, man, claiming his innocence. Currently, I'm the greatest rapper in the sense.